last thing India want at this stage is a run out. Amir Sohail picked the ball in the first attempt, then there would have been big trouble. This gives time for Azharuddin to come closer to the crease, and he makes his ground. So no problem at all.
Greeted with great enthusiasm and applause. That would have been a disaster for India had he gone. Everyone's got to keep his nerves now. It's in the mind. Ball spinning and beating him. Four. There's a fielder running around. He cuts it off just inside the fence. Azhar gets two. And Hussain has done a good job for Pakistan. Wish they did. And that is four runs. We've got a thick edge outside. And that's a boundary which India definitely needed badly. And Sourav Ganguly throwing the bat on everything. And Sourav Ganguly there throwing his bat and picking up four runs. Magnificent reply by the Indians, and what a terrific game we are having. Played a wonderful innings of 82, and with the medium fast bowling, bowler bowling from one end, I think the Indian batsman will try and take as many risks as possible against the spin of Mohammad Hussain. That's the best option. And we see here that the referee, Mike Dennis, is having the manager of the Indian team, along with the third umpire, having a chat. And obviously, they must have had something to discuss.
One thing the referee and the umpires can't control is the light. Not that capable.
Listen, I think the proceedings in the middle are handled by the two umpires, and they have been given this light meet here. But one feels that and this time Akif Javed failing to prevent the ball going over the boundary line, and a welcome relief for the Indian supporters who were desperately waiting for this boundary to come. And Sourav Ganguly this time beating a diving Akif Javed, and four more runs coming to
into perform at the moment. 48 from 42, still a pretty even contest, if in fact you can have an even contest in the dark.
Yes, and Rashid Latif making the change, bringing on Saqlain Mushtaq, realizing that the batsmen are going for the big hit to the spinners. I'm sure he's banking on Saqlain to get the breakthrough, and he has been pretty good in the past. Not this time. The economy rate is very high, and without picking a wicket, he has given away 42 runs of just six. So it is a gamble with Rashid Latif is taking, and one has to wait and see whether it's going to pay off or not.
Well, a wicket or two would make a big difference here. I think if India are to win, it's going to have to be Ganguly and Azharuddin to get them there. Very hard for a new batsman to come in under these conditions. What will he do? Will he look to push it around? Or will he look for the big hit? It's one off the first ball. I don't think Azharuddin's going to go for the big hit. I think Azhar's really going to have to play as well as he can, working the ball around into the gaps, getting the ones and twos, try and force the bowlers into making mistakes.
Yes, I think that one of these two has to stay till the end if India is to win. But I'm sure Rashid Latif has different plans. And with light as is now, one can see the shadows of the fielders and the batsmen. And virtually it's a floodlit match, a day match which is being played under floodlights.
Full toss, he's gone, hit it straight to mid-wicket. So the waist-high Fuldoss has done the trick for Saclane. Ezredin trying to work the ball into the gap, surprised by the ball.
And a full toss could bring it straight to Amir Sohail, and India losing its third wicket for 268.
Balls into the gap, they're looking for two. Jadeja coming back. It's a good throw to the keeper's end, but not quite good enough. Inzamam Al-Haq, and there's trouble for Ganguly. He's gone. He's gone for the calf, whether it's a cramp or he's... There's Ezredin at the square leg position at the striker's end. Ganguly must also maintain his ground as well. He can't even wander off out of the crease. Even if the runner's safe and he's out of his crease and the bails are taken off, then he can also be run out, so... Everyone needs to have their wits about them. Umpires, batsmen, fielders, and the television cameraman as well.
Well, ball to turn, ball in, ball in.
271 for three. Jadeja will be striking. Gives you an idea of how dull it is out there. Much easier when the batsman with the runner is not on strike, because all he has to do is hide by the square leg umpire and leave it up to the other two. But now the injured player comes back on strike. Mohammad Azharuddin just checking with the umpires which side he would like him to stand. Extras apart from one runner ball to win this game. Can they do it? Tension is rising. Nobody's leaving the ground. He's out. Not in. Down the wicket he goes. Akif Javed gets past the outside edge of the bat. Top of middle stump, and that's a very important wicket for Pakistan.
And that's one wicket they really wanted, because Sourav Ganguly was the man in form. And look at the jubilation on all the Pakistanis there. They're delighted with that wicket, and not only the players in the middle are delighted, so are the supporters. Losing their fourth wicket, an important one. 274 for four.
Sidhu, the new batsman, and that's a good start for him. Well, it appeared to be a bit of a blow losing Ganguly, but in hindsight it may be seen as the best thing that happened. He was struggling with an injury, a cramp or an injury. There was a runner out there. There was confusion all round. Sidhu's come out there, even in the gloom. At least he's fit and healthy. He can do his own running. And that four is very important in working that equation down. I need a couple more. It's a good start for Sidhu. Eight runs coming from the over. 279 for four.
Even Dhaka, with 34 runs being required and off 29 balls, there is going to be tremendous excitement.
He's given it out. Oh dear, oh dear. A loud appeal. Sidhu has been given out, LBW. And the tension and the drama mounts here at the National Stadium.
And once again, what a big wicket for Pakistan. Saclane Mushtaq.